Good afternoon and welcome to Christmas Carol Pipes, Advent to Epiphany. I'm Bryan Kirk, organist and music director at First Presbyterian Church of Glens Falls, New York, and this program comes to you from that location. I designed this program in an effort to present some Christmas-themed music using familiar and traditional Christmas carols. Unfortunately, right now we cannot sing many of our beloved carols, but I thought some music featuring the various colors and the wide sonic range of these two remarkable pipe organs would help us have a little bit of comfort, a little bit of joy, and also some hope. So, what we just heard was the chorale Fantasia by Johann Sebastian Bach, a kind of toccata-type piece based on In Dulce Jubilo. The next piece by Marcel Dupré, a great French organist, is a very quiet version of the same tune featuring the string sounds. The piece after that is by a cousin of Bach, and it uses some of the mutations and bright sounds of the gallery organ. You will also hear the zimbelstern in some of these pieces. The zimbelstern is a set of bells that go around and are traditionally used in Germany and other countries for Christmas music. So I hope you enjoy this afternoon's program. So the three settings of In Dulce Jubilo were to announce our concert like an overture. Now we begin with the next portion, which is about Advent, which means to prepare, or the coming of Christ. So one of the most famous chorale preludes in all of organ music is Wacket auf by Bach, and it features the trumpet stop in the left hand as the solo. And Bach actually specifies this particular combination of sounds on the organ for this piece. It is a very famous setting, and it was also in one of his cantatas. The piece after that, the Rorate Caeli, is an ornamented chorale, hence its title, by the great French organist Jean de Messieu, and it is based on the Advent antiphon, Drop Down Ye Heavens. And it is a very quiet, lyrical piece and features the Nazard stop and mutations of the organ. So those are our Advent pieces.
Thank you.
Now that we have had Advent, it's time for Christmas. So let's get a little closer to Bethlehem and to the manger. So we begin with a sprightly little trio. Actually, it's a duo with the tune Vom Himmel Hoch, which is a traditional German chorale. This is a very lively setting by Pachelbel. And yes, he wrote more music than the canon in D, as this piece will demonstrate. Both the little trio and the fugue feature the melody in the pedal. The first one is a very sprightly setting using, again, some cute sounding flutes with the zimbelstern. And then the fugue uses the more traditional plenum or regular sounds of the organ. And it gets very brilliant and very busy, kind of like the angels flying to announce the birth of Jesus.
Thank you.
Now we have two English carols. The first is a meditation on the Elizabethan tune Greensleeves, which originally had nothing to do with Christmas, but now, like many of our carols and other tunes, have been transferred into Christmas or more sacred meanings. This setting is by Richard Purvis, who was organist at Grace Cathedral in San Francisco for many years in the mid-20th century. It uses some of the unique colors of this organ, the clarinet, the English horn, the French horn, and the lush strings. After that, a sprightly little improvisation on the English tune, The Sussex Carol, which is on Christmas night, all Christians sing. And this will alternate between different versions of the cornets, or sounds that imitate the sound of trumpets on the organ. So I hope you enjoy these two Christmas carol settings.
Thank you.
So now that we are at the manger, it's time to get everyone in our Christmas cast here. So the shepherds have been traveling for a while, and so now it is Epiphany, the arrival of the wise men, the shepherds, or the magi. So two very famous tunes are the German chorale Wie schon leuchtet der Morgenstern, which is, in English, How Brightly Shines the Morning Star. This is a beautiful chorale prelude by the Danish composer Niels Gade, and it features the oboe stop. Then an improvisation on the old French carol, What is This Lovely Fragrance? You will hear the English horn, the major flute, and some lovely string sounds in a kind of church prelude, communion-style prelude. And then after that, a setting of We Three Kings, something like what I have done here on Christmas Eve. So I think We Three Kings is probably the best known of the Epiphany carols. And I think after we get through the end of that, we will know that they have indeed arrived. And of course, we need a good finale. And so here we have a setting of Hark the Herald Angels Sing. And so I thought about other organ pieces. There are so many pieces of great Christmas music out there. And many people said, oh, are you going to play this? Oh, are you going to play that? And what have you been doing during this pandemic? Well, I've been practicing, I've been playing, but I've been doing a lot of improvisation. And so I thought, maybe I'll just do one of those to offer as a festive finale. So during this time, I know it has been very tough and very hard for all of us, and especially singers, musicians, churches, and our choirs. So I hope the music that you have heard today and this setting will offer some joy, some solace, some comfort, and some hope as we move ahead. This piece will begin with a lush sound of strings and move into a louder setting and then a brilliant toccata flourish, somewhat like what I do for postludes on Sunday morning. So again, we are recording from the First Presbyterian Church of Glens Falls, New York. This building was built in 1929. Ralph Adams Cram was the architect. This building was the vision of the church then, and also of Louis and Charlotte Hyde. And the organs here are actually two instruments, the 1973 Casavant of 60 ranks in the gallery, and the 70 rank Reuter organ rebuilt by Foley-Baker in the last few years in the chancel. It's a total of 130 ranks, more than 7,000 pipes, and is one of the 100 largest organs in the country. We are very blessed by it. We do a lot of concerts and community outreach, and our church is very active in our community. And we invite you to join us on live streams and on webcasts as you can. And so thank you for being with us this afternoon. Have a Merry Christmas, a joyous New Year, and the happiest holidays to everyone, wherever and whatever you may be celebrating.